كيف؟ اوكي، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عائشة.
Okay. Can you spare 5 minutes of your time, or are you very
hurry? How long can you wait? If you're not in hurry, just let me finish introducing this class,
okay.
And then I can have the 5 minutes with you.
Alright. Inshallah. We'll be downstairs.
Okay, inshallah. Thank you very much. Okay, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. How many people do we have? Okay, inshallah, this will be the book that we will study. That's the Usul al-Fiqh, related to the fiqh study. I decided to give you this as a reward for what you did, to finish the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to be on the way to finish it. So inshallah, I hope you will appreciate it. And inshallah, I will try to see how to benefit you and to give you a proper foundation that inshallah you will be understanding what we will be talking about when we discuss the fiqh issues, inshallah. And the other thing that we might study also is the tafsir, usul tafsir. Usul tafsir, I am still looking for an appropriate book that should be dealt with. So until next week, I find something appropriate, we'll be studying this waraqat about usul al-fiqh. The book is easy and simple, and also it is in a form of poetry and also nathr. So originally Imam al-Juwayni, he is the one who wrote the book. So he wrote it not in a form of poetry, but somebody came afterward and make it in the form of poetry. You get it? So I will be dealing with both. I will translate the nathr for you, which is the original book, and then you go and memorize the poetry so that you will keep the meaning. And alhamdulillah, the poetry is very simple, very easy also. That's knowledge. You have to try. Imam al-Nawawi used to take, as we mentioned, 20 classes in a day. So we are taking only how many classes in a week? Only 2, 3, 4 classes. Salaam alaikum, people at the back. Join us. Sisters at the back, join us. Okay. So, inshallah, Fadil will take the copy of the book, and bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, he will give you the book. Since you are not many, you don't need to pay for the book. We will make copy free, inshallah. Either from the same sponsor or from the other sponsor, inshallah. But we'll give you free, inshallah ta'ala. You get it? And the tafsir, the usul tafsir also, as soon as I find the portion that we should study, we'll also grant it free for you. But as I said, please, I need memorization and clear understanding since you are not many. So I think it will be very easy for you to understand what is going to be said here. You get the idea? Okay, let me take 2 to 3 minutes to do something since I keep you here, inshallah. At least introducing the book. قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هذه ورقات تشتمل على فصول من أصول الفقه وهو لفظ مؤلف من جزئين مفردين أحدهما الأصول والآخر الفقه فالأصل ما يبنى عليه غيره والفرع ما ينبني على غيره والفقه معرفة الأحكام الشرعية التي طريقها الاجتهاد. Okay. مؤلف says هذه ورقات تشتمل على فصول. So he said these are some pages that I'm compiling, and you see he called it ورقات, right? The book, the whole thing about the book is only these pages. So that's why he called it waraqat. So according to my calculation, the whole waraqat is around 5 pages in this small compilation. 5 to 6 papers. That's why he said waraqatun. I mean, few pages on the topic of usul al-fiqh. And I classified based on chapters. تشتمل على فصول من أصول الفقه وهو لفظ مؤلف من مفردين. And أصول الفقه is a lafz, a lafz هو ما يتلفظ به, what you utter by your tongue. مؤلف من جزئين, it is the word that is constructed from two parts. One of them مفردين, each and every one of them is separated from each other. It has, you know, separate, its own separate meaning. أحدهما الأصول, the first lafz is أصول, right, أصول الفقه, the first one is أصول, والثاني الفقه, the second one is الفقه, so مؤلف من مفردين, الأصول, أصول الفقه, you get idea, so he will be talking about these two things, أصول الفقه. قال فالأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره, الأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره, الأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره, الأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره. الأصل is anything that you build something upon it. That's أصل. ما ينبني عليه غيره, anything that you build something upon it. What does that mean? Foundation, right? الأصل is the root, something that you build branches and other things upon it. That's the pillars. الأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره. Please do remember this. والفرع ما ينبني على غيره. الأصل is the opposite of الفرع. الأصل is the root. الفرع is the branch. الأصل is anything that you build something upon it. That's the foundations, right? So أصول الفقه means the foundation of فقه. You get it? Without it, do you understand فقه? It would be impossible, right? الأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره, anything that you built upon other things on it, this is أصل. You get it? الفقه, before the فقه, الفرع, which is the opposite of الأصل, ما ينبني على غيره, the thing that you built upon something. So that's the branches, right? The building that you place on the foundation, this is الفرع. So please do remember this. الأصل ما ينبني عليه غيره, والفعل والفرع ما ينبني على غيره. والفقه, والفقه معرفة الأحكام الشرعية, معرفة الأحكام الشرعية التي طريقها الاجتهاد. معرفة الأحكام الشرعية, knowing the Islamic rulings, التي طريقها الاجتهاد. The hukum of every single thing that Allah wants to talk about, the hukum of issues that are arising in this life, التي طريقها اجتهاد, the one that you can only know it through اجتهاد. You get it? The one that you know it through اجتهاد. This is fiqh. So I learned the usul al-fiqh, I learned nahu, I know the balagha, I know this and that, and I have all of those knowledge, tafsir, and I memorize Quran, I have the hadith with me, I have musal al-hadith. This will give me chance and ability to look at the text of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and extract ruling from it. Is that clear? That's fiqh. When we say fiqh, this is what we mean. Understanding, which is based on ijtihad. To use those formulas given to you by the scholars, which are the usul al-fiqh, to extract ruling from the verses of the Quran and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you get it? Do you have any questions upon this? Think, I give you a few seconds to have questions. Do you have any questions? التي طريقها الاجتهاد. معرفة الأحكام الشرعية التي طريقها الاجتهاد. معرفة الأحكام الشرعية التي طريقها الاجتهاد. That's fair. Now. It is supposed to be the lugha will extend up to 3:15, right? And then we'll have another class, and the other class will go up to 4 something before they make adhan. And this one also, the usul al-fiqh and the lugha, it will be like that. The luga will take 1 hour, 15 minutes, and the other one is going to take the other, other part of the time, which is around 1 hour or so, right? Mm. Inshallah. So be very patient, inshallah, you will get something. You don't have any question? Yes. Why do you want to choose? No, I'm asking you personally, why do you want to choose? No, I'm saying, do you want to choose and select some of the classes? Why do you want to choose? Just give me good justification, then I will advise you. Why? It's too long or it's too hard? No, inshallah, it is all about strategy in the way you learn. You see, just be patient for 1 or 2, 3 weeks. When you go home, you don't need to stay doing this for the rest of your life. If you can give this class, inshallah, 30 minutes to 1 hour is more than enough. Because every day we are not going to take a lot. When you take it, you read it, you can revise what we take from the from the class. You can revise it within 15 minutes. We just need the repetition and a clear understanding, and that's it. And the assignment, don't worry, we're not going to give you assignment a lot. You see, this one comes at the beginning, right? Because we need the definition of the biography of the author. You get the idea. In the future, it's not going to be like that. When assignment comes, it's going to be a very simple assignment that you can do it even walking on the way. You get the idea. The most important part is you being present in the class, inshallah. So it just needs from you a little bit of patience, and inshallah, you will appreciate it in the future, inshallah. Do you get it? Don't choose for the time being, but if you decide to choose, we will let you do so. But don't choose, this is my advice. Just come for a couple of weeks. If you still think that it is too much, then we can. Do you get the idea? I never stop any of my extra classes out of the university, regardless of the intensive course. So I always look at it as time management. How do I manage my time to do my things? You get it? And I see is that if I manage my time, I can do things that nobody can. I was doing my PhD. All of my colleagues, they are doing it. 80% of my life is given dawah, teaching. You'll be surprised, when did I have time to write? And I finished before them. And they don't have anything to do, except to focus on the study. You get it? Family to support, regardless of all of these, and I finished before many of them. So it's all about time management. You get the idea? Inshallah. Lugal Arabiya. لغة العربية ما ندرسها فقط النحو إن شاء الله in the future بإذن الله تعالى في المستقبل بإذن الله نتحدث باللغة لا القصد هو أن تكون المقدمة باللغة الإنجليزية واللغة العربية لكن in the future بإذن الله تعالى we're going to restrict ourselves to Arabic language إن شاء الله تعالى but if we go with the Arabic language now and then somebody says 80% is not understood. If we use Arabic language, then 100% is not going to be understood. So it will be discouraging. So we don't want this to happen, so we will maintain the English language first, and then inshallah in the future we'll move to Arabic language. So you stay inshallah. Say yes, inshallah. So please just be patient, Inshallah, we will make you happy in the future, inshallah. Any more question? I was thinking of adding, but I will not add because of the time. If you have any question, come up with it. No. هذا فقط للذين هم ما حفظوا بعد. ويريدنا المواصلة والشخص الذي يستطيع أن يحفظ في البيت لا يحتاج أن يتابع برامج أبدا، يحفظه في البيت، يحفظه مع البرنامج في المسجد، وهذا جيد، ما يحتاج إلى، القصد هو حفظ القرآن الكريم بأي طريقة كانت. As I said in the beginning, the idea of having this class is to make you something. You get the idea. And it needs dedication. And these are the strategies that we have to follow. I know it is so difficult, that's why I told you that about the patience with the knowledge and the learning process. You get the idea. So the first time you might find it very difficult. But I'm telling you, we are not doing what you're supposed to do. If we are doing what we are supposed to do, this time is not enough. And the book we are studying, they are not enough. We will go more than that. You get the idea. But I'm just thinking that we should start with these simple things. The general class will just have only two books, which is the Arabic and the Fiqh, right? When it comes to the specific class for people who memorize Quran, I decided to make it like that because I think they would understand more than the rest. Do you get it? So what I want you to do is, please do exercise patience, a lot of patience, and inshallah, in a few months to come, or a few weeks, inshallah, you're going to enjoy the class. You never think of going, inshallah. Inshallah. As I said, it's about time management. When you take the lesson in the class, you go home, squeeze some of your time, just sit for it. It will not take more than 30 minutes. And you have 24 hours, so you can study whatever you study. You can play, you can relax, you can rest. But this one, just be very dedicated to it. 30 minutes is more than enough. I just need in a day from you 30 minutes. And I think we can give it, right? It's so simple, please light up. If you find it difficult in the future, then let me know, then you make the selection. You get the idea. It is still upon what we said earlier, but I think it is part of my job to advise you wisely. You get it. We might set up a choice for everyone, but my job is to advise you wisely, and then you take a decision in the future. You get it. Any more questions? Fatih, can you send the link of the website?
Okay.
Through the email.
Yeah.
When he sends email, does it reach you? Okay, he will send after this the link, inshallah, through that email. Inshallah. We'll put all of our lectures there, and I just designed the website also to be a place that I will meet my students and to be easy for the people who are having questions, inshallah. Maybe later. 2 minutes left. Any question? No, you can ask general questions. You can ask general questions. It doesn't matter. Any question can count. Of course, the priority is you to start with the questions that, that are related to what we study. But if you don't have them, you can just come up with any other questions. You don't wait for people to finish the questions related to the class. No, as long as you have questions, you just come up and ask them. And with me, you don't even need to ask about the relation or not. You don't need to introduce that the question is not related to the lesson. You just ask. Inshallah, I will give you the answer, inshallah. Mm-hmm. Barakallah. So is that okay? So please, I will emphasize more. Don't run. Inshallah. We need your presence here. Without you, we will not succeed. You get it? You can see the amount is how many? Around 8, right? If you go, it will become 7. And then somebody will take it sunnah. I should go 6. And then we will not find anyone. Then I will be sitting with nobody here. So please, do come and do exercise patiently. Be the light, Allah, you will be happy, inshallah. Anything else? Nothing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and increase your patience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide each and every one of us to the truth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase your knowledge and your sincerity. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you among the best people who are Ahlul Quran wa khasatullahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let you see the appreciation of your patience in this life when you meet Him, inshallah, in the hereafter. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum. it was with me, then I kept it. Why don't you take from Fatih and copy from that? But please.
I prefer to ask the students about, because the way they print, if they take this book, they'll print it sideways on the paper like this. But
and
we
can
make
it
like
book.
A book like this. If we print it from online, we find the PDF and we print it from online. It's more easier.
So why don't you make it?
Yeah.
Because I think they will appreciate it more than
the
PDF.